So this is probably what you think of when you picture an atom, right? The thing is, the central part of this model is just plain inaccurate. Scientists recently found that the nucleus of some atoms don't look like this at all, and it's causing a ruckus because, well, this newfound shape straight up shouldn't exist. When you learned about atoms in school, you probably learned about a couple of different models, and one thing was likely always the same. The nucleus was spherical, but it turns out that might have been too simple. Atomic nuclei are made up of protons and neutrons that are held together by the strong nuclear force, one of the universe's fundamental forces. And based on this, one might assume that they would be more or less spherical. In reality, though, most nuclei are deformed to some extent. They can be elongated into football shapes or squished into disks, but as long as they're symmetrical, everything in physics is just fine and dandy. Here's the problem, though. We just found a nucleus that isn't symmetrical, and that is a huge deal, because symmetry is a very important cornerstone to many of the theories that we use to understand our universe. In particle physics, there's a theory called cp-symmetry, which is the combination of charge symmetry and parity. Charge symmetry is the idea that if you flip the charge of an atom, the physics of the atom shouldn't change. This is the basis to our understanding of antimatter. If you flip the charge in a regular atom, you get an anti-atom, and the physics should work exactly the same. Similarly, parity is the idea that if you invert the spatial coordinates of a system, the physics also shouldn't change. Our hands, for example, show parity. If you move one hand like this, you can mirror it with your other hand, and it works the same way. Theoretically, atoms should behave this way too. So back to the new hotness. Some Scotland-based scientists confirmed a pear-shaped nucleus exists. A pear shape, you guys! A pear! The most exciting shape of all the fruits! Scientists had previously found asymmetrical nuclei in the isotopes radium-224 and 226, but this time they confirmed it also in barium-144, which is a comparatively lighter atom. And how did they do that, you ask? I'm glad you asked. They just looked for octopole transitions in the gamma ray emissions of excited Ba-144 nuclei. Casual. And the surprisingly pear-shaped nuclei they found had uneven distributions of mass and charge, which according to currently accepted models of physics, like cp-symmetry, just shouldn't exist. But they do! And the scientists think that could have some very big implications. Our current models predict the symmetry of antimatter and matter, and also the flow of time. But the scientists think that these nuclei being asymmetrical could explain why these things don't function symmetrically either. If some atomic nuclei aren't symmetrical, they're claiming, it could explain why we can't seem to find antimatter in our universe, and why time always flows from past to future, and therefore why time travel could likely be impossible. These are some pretty hefty claims, though, and as always, more research is needed before we could prove anything, but it's pretty amazing that such a tiny discovery could have such huge implications, isn't it? Special thanks to Domain.com for sponsoring this episode of Seeker. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. Start sharing your ideas with the world on a professional website. Domain.com can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space to .family or pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. If tiny science gets you as excited as a barium-144 nucleus, you should watch Julian's video here about just how small life can actually get. And fun fact, about 99.9% of an atom is empty space. Without it, all of humanity would be the size of a sugar cube. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching Seeker.